Australian bands that talk directly to the suburbs of the cities where most of us live. Horror Movie was the 6:30 news. All my friends are getting married, and they were getting married. And You Just Like Me Because I'm Good in Bed was, well, obvious. It all ended in 1979, leaving in its wake seven albums, reviews that claimed that a lot of the songs were to do with genitals, and a torrent of weeping TV boppers. A decade later, and they're at it again. Why?
What? Well, his pension's due next year. If we don't do it now, mate, there'll be a clash.
Seriously?
I was bored. I wanted something to do over the summer, you know?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, I reckon that basically the industry at the moment's a little bit too bloody serious. And one thing, this band, it was serious in what it was about to do, but I think it exuded fun and having a good time. I think it's what this industry needs, a good dose of fun.
The tour sees Skyhooks go back from whence they came.
Where it all started was in the pubs, you know, and I mean, things are getting tight. I mean, petrol's getting really expensive, so we figured you might as well go back out to the streets where it all happened and get back into that vibe, and it's like, it's still a good place to play in a pub. I mean, concerts, sometimes when you're sitting up the bleachers, you pay $29, $34, and you're sort of looking down there, and you find they're miming. But it's a bit hard sometimes.
Well, obviously you're going to do the pub run and then hope to broaden it out to a national concert tour.
Oh, yeah, I think it's a matter of just seeing what happens. I mean, realistically, we've approached it as a tour to go on the road for X amount of dates over Christmas. It's a nostalgia tour with two new songs.
We know what Red's been up to, but do you want to just run through what you and the other guys...
I've got a 2.5-minute live variety program. I host Lotto on Wednesday nights.
Every week, millions of people in Victoria hate him because he pulls the wrong numbers out.
Someone's really happy and everyone else hates him. What have the other guys been up to? You want to just run through it all?
Actually, Freddie still plays real well, actually. He plays a regular gig with Frankie J. Holden on Fridays and Saturdays down in Melbourne at the Roxy. Bongo sold his nightclub a couple of years back and did a bit of travelling, went over to South America and teamed up with Ronald Biggs.
Our mate.
You went over there too, didn't
you? Yeah. He shot a documentary with Ronald Biggs.
He's sort of working on that and finishing that up. Greg's sort of like onto the managerial role. He manages a little AC/DC cover band called Back in Black.
How was it when you got back together?
How's it look?
I'm having a good time. Well, it's a bit hard for it. I mean, you know, and he works, you know, sort of half a day a week. And sort of, I work probably, if you had my bits up, it's probably about 3/4 of the day of the week. But, it's funny. When you get action, when we got in and played, that was quite funny, because it's, like, I suppose, 14 years since we recorded together in this lineup.
It's really great to be with the guys again. I hadn't realised how much I had missed being with them and being on the road and playing the great old songs again.